Morning, students. Today we will start the next chapter from the Flamingo book. The chapter name is Lost Spring. Now, before we continue with the chapter, let me tell you the symbolic meaning of this particular word or the chapter name. You can say Lost Spring: Stories of Stolen Childhood by Annie Jack. You might have studied the poem Seven Ages by William Shakespeare in class 9. In that Seven Ages poem, William Shakespeare has divided the stages of a human being into seven. And the most important stage, as we consider, is referred as childhood. Yes or no? Yes. Because that symbolizes the innocence, the imagination, and the carefree look. In the same way, this particular story also talks about the lost spring. Here, spring symbolizes the innocence and the childhood. But this chapter, it says that the children, those who have lost their spring or the childhood, that is why this refers as Lost Spring. Clear? Now coming to the author, Annie Jung. Now she was a prolific writer, you can say, and she has talked about, or her writing always talks about, the poverty, or you can say the children, those who belong to the deprived section. She has written so many important novels and books, and most of her novels and books talks about only one important thing, that is the deprived class or a society which is not to be entertained by the higher class people. In this chapter also, this particular chapter has been divided into two parts. The first, we will look into the life of Sahibe Alam, and the second one is about Mukesh. The first chapter, or the first part, talks about Sahibe Alam, who is a ragtag and who lives in Simapuri, and Simapuri is in Delhi. As you know, that the chapter starts with the author, that is Annie Jung, she encounters Sahibe Alam. Sahibe Alam, he is a rag picker. He lives in Simapuri, Delhi. His only job is to move around along with his barefoot friends and to collect the rags. One day it so happens that he meets author, and she asks the question that, why are you not wearing chappals? For this reply, he says that, I don't have. And some of the other boys says that even if they have, then the mothers won't allow to have them, those, because they belong to a deprived class of section. In a long run, one day it so happens that Sahibe Alam again encounters with Annie Jung, and at that point of time she says that, why are you not going to school? He says, there is no school in the neighborhood. And then Annie Jung says that, if I'll make a school, will you come? He says, of course I'll come. After some days, Sahibe Alam comes to Annie Jung and he says, is your school ready? But the school is not something that can be built in a day or two. So these kind of things can be seen in every part of life, that the fake promises which have been made by the people, but generally things have not been fulfilled. Sahibe Alam is a rag picker, and rag picking is the only source of survival for the people of Simapuri. Now these people, Sahibe Alam and his family, they have come from Bangladesh, Dhaka, you can say. It was in the year 1971 when these people, they have come to Delhi or Simapuri, you can say, which is a slum area, and they have been living in that particular place for so many years. And these people are referred as squatters. Squatters means people, those who live without paying rent. Now these people, they go for garbage picking, and for them garbage is considered as gold. Let me tell you once again, garbage is considered as gold. Why? And this is the figure of speech used in this particular line, is metaphor. That means the importance of that garbage is being given as gold. Gold is very expensive, and for them garbage is very expensive because it is their livelihood. It is something which that they need to have for their survival. As we know that Sahibe Alam, his name symbolizes the Lord of Universe. But it is very difficult for him to understand that what is the actual meaning of that thing. Because if he comes to know that what is the actual meaning of his name, he will not be able to know that. As Annie Jung also says that she encounters Sahibe Alam for a later period. She goes to that particular place, Simapuri, where she encounters the other children also. That particular place is so dirty, it is unhygienic, and there is a coexistence of animal and human being. There lives almost 10,000 rag pickers, where you can say that rag picking is the only means of survival. And garbage has two different meanings. One is literal and one is symbolic. And these two meanings refers to two different things for elders and children. For children, garbage is something which is wrapped and it is full of wonders. But for elders, it is the means of survival. That is very, very important. After some days, Anijan again looks at Sahib-e Alam. But this time, Sahib-e Alam is in a new form, you can say. He is not his old business of rag picking, but this time he is working for someone else. Instead of having the carry bag, he is having a steel canister. Because this time he is working under a person, or he is working in a tea stall. And he also says that, I get 800 rupees and 3 times a meal. But the most important question is that he has lost his carefree look. Because once you can say that Sahib-e Alam was his own master, but now he is working under someone. So this is the life of those children, those who have been deprived from their education. They live in a poverty life and their only thing is that they have to survive. And survival in Simhapuri means rag picking only. Hope you understood. Please. Good morning, students. Now, yesterday we have seen that the chapter was Lost Pig. It was written by Anish Jha, and we have seen this lifestyle or the life story of Sahib-e Alam. And we have finished that. Today we'll continue the chapter, and it is part 2, that is about Mukesh's life. Mukesh says that I want to be a motor mechanic. But Mukesh lives in a place which place has been referred as bangle industry, that is Firozabad. Firozabad is a place which is famous for making bangles. And his family also involves or indulges in making bangles from not only for this 1 year, or you can say, it is from past generation to generation. But at that point of time, a boy who belongs to Firozabad, a place which is only famous for making bangles, in that particular community, a child wants to be a motor mechanic. Does it seem to be like something strange? Yes, of course. But we will see whether he will be able to achieve this dream or not. Clear? So as the chapter moves on, the first part, we see that Anish Jha encounters this person, that is Mukesh. And she asks the question that, what is your ambition? And he says, I want to be a motor mechanic. But he says that the place where I live, it is only famous for making bangles. And my family also indulges in the same business. He says, my family member consists of my father, my elder brother and himself, and elder brother's wife, where entire family lives together. And the place where they live, it is something which can be referred as a slum again, and which is where people live, almost 20,000 people live over there. And that place is something which has been surrounded by so many children, and these children are also do the work of making bangles. As the chapter continues, we see that Mukesh is very happy to take Anish Jha to his dwelling place, the place where he has been living, the place where almost 20,000 children have been working in dinghy cells. Dinghy cells are the places where these children, they sit together along with their families and they have been busy in making bangles. Now, Mukesh's grandmother, the one who has been working in this particular profession, you can say, from the last so many years. Now, she says that this is a God-given lineage. Can this ever be broken? Yes, that's a big question over here. Because Mukesh is a one person who lives in this particular place, that is Firozabad. His family engages himself in making bangles, but he has a big dream, he has a big ambition for his life, that he wants to be a motor mechanic. Can this ever be fulfilled? So it says, that is, the grandmother says that her own husband, he's been working in this particular profession for so many years and he has lost his eyesight also. The story moves on and it continues with one of the most important characters, that is Savita, a very young girl, the one who has been sitting next to the grandmother and she's been making the bangle. She's been busy in making that red color, orange, or you can say different colors of bangle which have been kept in all around. There's a huge mound of bangles which have been kept because you can see all different colors of bangle there. But she doesn't know the auspiciousness, or you can say the purity or the sanctity of that red bangle what she's been making over here. But the lady or the grandmother who's been sitting next to her, she knows the auspiciousness of that particular red bangle. Because day when she was young, her hands were being filled with red bangles. The same will happen with Savita also. But she says, though she has the red color bangles on her hand, but she has lost the eyesight because of working in this particular dingy sense for many years. And this is the story of an impoverished family where they don't have enough money to feed their families or to continue with a good survival means, you can say. Anish Jain asked a question to Mukesh that why you people not organize yourself into a cooperative? The question is something which is very important, but the answer which is being given by Mukesh is that even if they organize themselves into a cooperative, then also the people like the sahukars, the middlemen, the politicians, the bureaucrats, they will never give a chance to live them freely. They will try to suppress them, they will try to make them feel that you are of nowhere. So he says that even if we make organize a cooperative, then also the life will be a miserable life for them. And he also says that, now Anish Jain says, she says that, I see two distinct worlds, a world which is being suppressed and the other world, the one which suppresses the other people. That is the two different worlds, a world which is full of sympathy and the next world is that full of greed, where you can see the vicious circle of the middlemen, the people like the bureaucrats. They try to capture or they try to suppress the feelings of, you can say, the poverty stricken people, and where it lies the Mukesh family. He wants to have lot of, he has lot of dreams, he wants to achieve those ambitions in his life. But the only question is that, will he be able to fulfill them? Because he doesn't have that much of money. He has ambitions, he has power. He wants to live his life, but he will never be able to get that much of money to fulfill the needs for his family. Here Anish Jain makes the question again. She says, I will help you. But the only thing is that you should not stop your ambition and you should not stop looking at your dream. Because dreams can only come true when you have the power to see them. For this, Mukesh says, his only ambition is that he wants to be a motor mechanic. At that point of time, Anish Jain looks up and she looks at an aeroplane flies over Firozabad. He says, do you have any other dreams also, Mukesh? He says, no, I have only one ambition and one day I will be able to achieve that. So hope Anish Jain will help Mukesh to fulfill his dream and to live a life which will make him realize not only for his this person, that will give an ambition to all the people, those who are residing in Firozabad.